So have you guys heard of Uber Air?
No, I haven't. Would you have to meet at a certain area, like a helicopter pad? And what if there's not like a helicopter pad near you?
Welcome to another episode of Business Beats. This time we'll be talking about convenience and cost. So Mon, have you ever thought about traveling through Uber Air to get to uni or maybe even a submarine?
Well, I haven't, but that would be pretty cool if I could. So consumer demand for time convenience and time efficiency has been really pushing businesses to think outside the box. So let's talk to some UNSW students and see how they value convenience in their lives.
So guys, how much do you value convenience?
I'm not entirely sure about spending a lot of money on convenience.
With like things like Uber Eats and that sort of thing, it saves you having to drive down to the shop and get it yourself.
I would say the convenience from Uber Eats isn't as worth the premium you're paying for the price, like delivering bubble tea and stuff, I think is kind of dumb.
If you look at the generations, like the millennials and Generation Z, or even to a certain extent Generation Y, they are so much more online. So they are willing to pay extra for here and now, right? So all of us have become so used to getting things with the press of a button.
So have you guys ever sort of paid for convenience, for example, Uber or Ola?
I haven't used either of those, no.
I've used Uber a couple of times.
We use Uber a lot to like, get home from late nights and that sort of thing, because it's better than public transport.
I use Uber Eats every time I'm not bothered.
Like, I've used Uber, and I would say, but it wasn't really a convenience thing, it was more like Uber's cheaper than the taxi.
So have you guys thought of ever using Uber Air? So you travel by helicopter, for example?
No, I don't think that would be for me.
Yeah, I don't see how it would be any more useful.
I would consider flying to have a lot more risk.
Would it even be able to land here? Is there a spot for it to land? That would be kind of weird.
Michael, has that changed your mind on how you travel to uni every day?
Well, I mean, I drive every day to uni, so I'm always willing to pay that cost for convenience. Personally, I'm pretty good in set my ways, but it might have changed yours.
So we'll see you next time on our next episode of Business Beats.